Om Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam Om. In the three chapters of the Gita, the second, third and fourth chapters, which have gone by, Krishna has primarily discussed two topics. One is regarding sadhana and the other is regarding lifestyle. With regard to the sadhana, spiritual discipline, Krishna has made it very clear that everyone has to go through karma yoga sadhana and jnana yoga sadhana to attain liberation. And there is no choice with regard to these two sadhanas. And we should know the reason also for that. Between karma yoga and jnana yoga, there is no choice because karma yoga is the means to come to jnana yoga. Karma yoga is the sadhanam, jnana yoga is the sadhya. Karma yoga is not a means for liberation. Karma yoga is only a means to come to jnana yoga. And jnana yoga is the means to liberation. Therefore, these three things and their relationship should be very clear. Karma yoga is the means, jnana yoga is the end, jnana yoga is the means, moksha is the end. And we can never talk about a choice between means and the end. You can have a choice between two types of means, whether this means is better or that means is better. A choice is possible. Like reaching the temple, you can have two roads and you can choose between two roads. Similarly, you can have a choice between two types of ends. Sadhyayor madhye vikalpaha sambhavati, sadhanayor madhye vikalpaha sambhavati. But you cannot have a choice between means and end. I have given an example also before. When a person wants to choose between two pants, whether this pant is better or that pant is better, he can choose. Similarly, when there are two or more shirts, he can stand in front of it and ask the question whether this shirt is better or that shirt is better. Between two shirts, there can be choice. Between two pants, there can be choice. Because choice is only between similars. But can there be a choice whether today I should wear pant or shirt? Class ku varathuk edha podundu varanum. I hope you don't do that. You can never have a choice between these two because they are not similars. Similarly, karma yoga and jnana yoga, you can never choose between the two because they are not similar. Karma yoga is the means, jnana yoga is the end. Whoever wants the end will have to necessarily take the means also. How can you choose the end without choosing or going through the means? Similarly, if I have to choose the means, I have to necessarily choose the end also, because choosing the means is valid and meaningful only if I have chosen the end also. Getting into a bus is meaningful only when you have chosen not only the bus but also the destination. You cannot choose the bus without choosing the destination. Now, we are not getting into the bus for a joy ride. Similarly, if you have chosen the destination, you have to necessarily choose the means also. Suppose I go to a doctor and I say that I have got a stomach pain. I want to remove this stomach pain, nivritti is my end. And the doctor says, wonderful, you have chosen health, freedom from pain, you have to take this tablet. And I argue, I am only interested in removing the pain. I don't want to take the tablet. Then doctor will not give medicine for the stomach pain. Doctor will have to give medicine for madness. So, if I choose the end of removing the pain, I have to choose the means also. Therefore, choosing the means and the end is complementary. One choice will validate the other choice, and the other choice will validate the first choice. Therefore, never ask the question, should I follow karma yoga or jnana yoga? It is meaningless question, because karma yoga is the sadhanam to come to jnana yoga. And between jnana yoga and moksha also, you cannot choose one, because jnana yoga is the means for liberation. So, with regard to karma yoga, jnana yoga is the end. And with regard to moksha, jnana yoga is the means. Just like a person occupies both the father status and the son status, how with regard to his son, he is the father, and with regard to his father, he is the son. Rama is father from the standpoint of Lavakusha, and Rama is the son from the standpoint of Dasharatha. Similarly, Jnana Yoga is means or end. Kata enna badil solanam? You should not answer. Na eppa kelvi kettalum, remember, generally, you should not answer. When I ask the question, Jnana Yoga is a means or end, you should ask the question, from whose standpoint? If I ask, Rama is father or son, never answer the question, from whose standpoint? Remember, from karma yoga standpoint, jnana yoga is the end. Karma yoga has to culminate in jnana yoga. And from moksha angle, jnana yoga is the means. So this alone, Krishna struggled and struggled and struggled and struggled, and he thinks that he has communicated. But Arjuna continues to have problems, but he seems to be clear to some extent. Yada te moha kalilam buddhirvyatitarishyati tadagantasi nirvedam shrotavyasya shrutasya cha shruti vipratipannate yadasthasyati nishchala samadhavachala buddhihi tadayogama vapsyati. In these two verses of the second chapter, Krishna has clarified Arjuna karma yoga will lead you to jnana yoga, and jnana yoga will lead you to liberation. So this is one part of the teaching. This is the teaching from the angle of sadhana. And Krishna had to teach this because there is a lot of confusion with regard to sadhana. Still there are people who think that karma yoga and jnana yoga are alternative means of liberation. Still majority of people think, and they talk about different paths to liberation. If you are an active person, you attain moksha through karma. If you are an intellectual person, you attain moksha through jnana yoga. Nee karma paathula poikyo, naa jnana paathula poren, rendu verum mokshathile vechindu hello solikiram. Even now there is a very big confusion. Shankaracharya struggles to clarify this confusion, and he says karma yoga cannot lead you to liberation. It will take you to jnana yoga. Jnana yoga will lead to liberation. This is one part of teaching. Then there is a second part of teaching also with regard to the lifestyle. Because a person can lead two types of lifestyle. One is life of activity in society, and the other is life of seclusion and withdrawal. Pravritti or nivritti, life of work or life of withdrawal, life in society or life in seclusion. So life of activity is called grihastha ashrama, and life of withdrawal is called sannyasa ashrama. Thus there are two ashramas open to every human being. In fact, in the olden days, after Gurukula Vasa for 15-20 years, for every individual, both ashramas are open. One can either get married and take to grihastha ashrama, or one can take to sannyasa and take to a life of seclusion. Now, with regard to this lifestyle, we use the Sanskrit word nishtha. So, previously I talked about the sadhana topic. Now, the second topic in the Gita is nishtha topic. Nishtha means what? Lifestyle. And with regard to these two lifestyles, main two lifestyles, what is Krishna's teaching? Krishna wants to point out that with regard to the lifestyle, a person has got a choice. With regard to karma yoga and jnana yoga, there is no choice. Everyone has to go through karma, everyone has to go through jnanam, there is no choice. So sadhana yoho vikalpaha nasti, vikalpaha shuna choice, there is no choice. But nishtayor madhye, between two types of lifestyle, there is a choice. Therefore Krishna wants to say, a human being can get married and live a life of a grihastha, or a human being can become a monk, a sannyasi, and live a life of seclusion. But what Krishna wants to emphasize is, whatever be your lifestyle, you don't have a choice with regard to sadhana. That means what? In both the ashramas, one has to follow karma as well as jnana. In both the ashramas, one has to follow karma as well as jnana. And that karma alone is called ashrama dharma. So, grihasthashrama dharma will be the karma yoga of a grihastha. Sannyasa ashrama dharma will be the karma yoga for a sannyasi. A grihastha will keep the sacred thread. A sannyasi uses a danda. That danda is like the sacred thread. Grihastha has got rituals and prayers and pujas and parayanams, and sannyasi also has got rituals, prayers, pujas, parayanam. The type of parayanams vary. For grihastha, Vishnu Sahasranama, etc. are emphasized. For a sannyasi, Upanishad, Bhashyam, etc. are emphasized. Puja is required. For a grihastha, Saguna Ishwara Namas are given, like Namashivaya, Narayanaya, etc. For a sannyasi, Upanishad Mahavakya Mantras are given for Japa. Or Omkara Japa, Hamsa Mantra Japa, Mahavakya Japa. Appa rendu verukum enna? The puja, etc. are common because both require what? The necessary mental condition to come to Jnana Yoga. A sannyasi also should qualify himself to enter Jnana Yoga. A grihastha also should qualify himself or herself to come to Jnana Yoga. Appa Krishna enna solrar? Take to any ashrama, but go through swadharma. And following swadharma is called karma yoga. And by following swadharma, what will happen? You will smoothly come to jnana yoga. And once you are ready for jnana yoga, Krishna says, both grihastha and sannyasi should come to Jnana Yoga, which is Vedanta Vicharaha self-inquiry. Grihastha also must approach a guru and do self-inquiry. Sannyasi also must approach a guru and do self-inquiry. Adhanala, rendu verum karma yogam panniyahanam, rendu verum Jnana Yogam mulamahum poyahanam, and both of them will get liberated. Therefore, what is the conclusion? In sadhana, there is no choice. In lifestyle, you have a choice. And if you ask which lifestyle is better, as I had told you before, both lifestyles have their own plus and minus points. In grihasthashrama, there are a lot of plus points. Some of you may wonder, Swamiji, If there is no plus points, nobody will be entering grihasthashrama at all. All Kalyana mandapams are booked 2 years before, indicating that they are seeing something. Either there is an actual plus point or a perceived plus point. So, certainly there are plus points. The plus point is ideal for following Pancha Mahayajna, doing lot of noble service to the society. Grihasthashrama is useful. And there is security is there. In fact, many people get only for the sake of security. Vayasu kaalathile oru kuzhandha nammala gavanichupane, avan gavanichupana maatana adu vera vishayam. But there is a hope that the children will take care. Security. And I can have bank balance. And I can have ornaments. I can have shares. I can have LIC. All sannyasi cannot do all those things. Cannot have life insurance. He cannot have gold, he cannot have shares, he cannot own a house, he cannot have anything. So therefore, grihasthashrama has got lot of support. Security is there, but the minus point is what? Equal responsibility. LKG admission lendu aarambikam. In fact, even before you get a child, you should work for admission. And now for the admission, what amount you have to give, that alone we used for our entire education. So therefore, security is plus point, responsibility is minus point. In the sense, responsibility means anxiety. What will happen to child? Whether he will get Swamiji 10th, onga blessing narevanam. 10th examination vanda sannyasi kitta nariya aalugal varuva. You will find that Swamiji, my son is writing 10th. Swamiji, my son is writing 12th. Special blessing. Anxiety is there. And if you are forward community, almost doomed. In sannyas ashrama, there is no responsibility. No wife, no husband, no children. You need not bother about anything. Pasicha, bhavati, bhikshan, dehi, shulavandiyadu. Aaravadu jadam boduva. Somebody will give bhiksha. That is all. So there is no responsibility, but there is no security also. So which is plus, which is minus? Every ashrama has got its own plus and minus points. And therefore Krishna wants to say that take to any ashrama and pursue both the sadhanas and get liberation. So thus, sadhana teaching, nishtha teaching, both Krishna has given in chapter 2, 3 and 4. Now Arjuna wants further clarity regarding this. And therefore first, he wants to ask about the nishtha or lifestyle. Because the problem is, once choice is given, there is a headache. Always decision making is difficult. Suppose you get the admission for your son in one university only, no problem. Suppose there are two or more universities, problem. Similarly, you want son-in-law or daughter-in-law, there is only one available, no headache. Bhagavan perla bharata pottu kalyanam panna vendida. But you have got 5 jadakams and all of them are perfectly matching, all are fine ones. Edha choose pandrathu? Headache. The greatest problem in life is decision making, and that's why we always either postpone or avoid or ask Swamiji. So that you can wash off the hands and avar dalela achada potulla neenga solli dhaan vannen solli. We don't want to make decision because we don't want to face the consequences of our decision. We don't have the mental strength. And therefore, Arjuna also faces the same problem. Krishna, you are telling both ashramas are okay. Now, what should I do? Na enna pannan solliyudungala. So, if you see in the 4th chapter, Krishna has talked about both grihasthashrama jnani as well as sannyasa ashrama jnani. Tyaktva karma phala sangam nitya tripto nirashrayaha karmanyabhipravrittopi naiva kinchit karoti saha nirashiryata chittatma tyakta sarva parigrahaha shariram kevalam karma kurvannapnoti kilbisham. So one verse talks about a grihastha jnani who is in grihastha ashrama and he has attained knowledge. And another verse talks about a sannyasi who has attained jnana. So that means you can be in any one of the ashramas. And since Krishna has talked about both ashramas, Arjuna again is confused. Naan enna pannanum. And emotionally his mind votes for sannyasa now. You know why? Because he has to kill his people. Itharnaal sannyasa patti pesave illa kaach mooch. So when everything is fine, nobody wants to think of sannyasa. But when there are problems all over, Swamiji thale pichindu onga ashramathu vandurana. But then I have to do my thalaipikal, isn't it? And I don't have even thalai for pikal, you know. At least you can do that. I cannot even do that. So therefore, when problems come, we have this problem. Therefore, Arjuna, in crisis, he wants to escape. And therefore, he wants Krishna's endorsement. And therefore, the fifth chapter begins with the same nishtha confusion. Confusion regarding the lifestyle. Whether sannyasa is better or grihasthashrama is better. It is with this background the teaching starts. And Krishna wants to clarify all about sannyasa. That's why the very chapter is called Sannyasa Yogaha or Karma Sannyasa Yogaha. Krishna is going to threadbare analyze what is sannyasa. And the beauty is, in spite of this clear analysis, Arjuna manages to have confusion further also. In fact, he makes the omnipotent Krishna himself helpless. Sometimes the students are so powerful that even the best teacher they make helpless. Because you find in the 18th chapter also, Arjuna asks the same question. Sannyasastu mahabaho tattvamichhami veditum tyagasya charishikesha prithakkeshi nishudana. In the 18th chapter also he asks about sannyasa. In the 5th chapter also he asks the same topic. With this background we will have to enter the chapter. We will read the first verse. Atha panchamo dhyayaha. Arjuna uvacha. Sannyasam karmanam Krishna. Punaryogam cha shamsasi. Yachrejayetayorekam. Tanme bruhi sunishchitam. So in spite of Krishna's clear teaching, Arjuna continues to have confusion, and therefore he asks the question in the beginning of this chapter. Arjunaha uvacha. Arjuna asked Lord Krishna. And what did he ask? Hey Krishna, you are glorifying both the ashramas. So this is sometimes the problem in our scriptures. You will find the grihastha ashrama is also glorified. And sannyasa ashrama is also glorified. In fact, grihastha is supposed to be the pillar of the society who nourishes all the other three ashramas. Because all the other three ashramas live on bhiksha. Brahmachari has to live on bhiksha alone. Vanaprasthi has to live on bhiksha alone. sannyasi also has to live on bhiksha alone. So if the three ashramas have to receive bhiksha, somebody has to suppose grihastha also start living on bhiksha, who will give? So therefore so grihastha has to give bhiksha, and therefore grihastha ashrama is glorified in Hinduism. There are certain other monastic religions who glorify the sannyasis and they bring down grihastha ashrama. In certain religions, even in Hinduism itself, there are certain sampradayas who glorify sannyasis and who criticize grihastha ashrama. They say, don't join the grihastha, romba pakkathula pohade, attachment ottindudum, avalta pohade, ava kuda veetla thangade. But that is not Hindu culture, that is not Vedic culture. Grihastha ashrama is a glorious ashrama. Help a person in spiritual sadhana. So when you call Ramana ashram, Ramakrishna ashram, this ashramam, etc., why do you call them ashrama? Because that is a place of spiritual sadhana. So when you use the word ashrama, it is a place of spiritual sadhana. Even family life is called grihastha ashrama, which means our Shastra tells, in family also one can follow spiritual sadhana. And therefore, grihastha ashrama is never inferior ashrama. And therefore, hey Krishna, you have glorified yogam shamsasi. Yogaha means the karma nishtha, the lifestyle of a grihastha. Lifestyle of activity, lifestyle of social involvement. That is the meaning of yogaha. In short, grihastha ashramaha. Shamsasi, you are glorifying. Where has Krishna glorified? In the previous chapter, tyaktva karma phala sangam. Nitya tripto nirashrayaha karmani abhipravrittopi naiva kinchit karoti saha. Grihasthashrami jnani is so glorious that he lives amidst activity and relationship, but still he is like the lotus leaf in water, unaffected by that. In the third chapter, Krishna gave the example of Janaka Maharaja, who was in the society, but he was untainted. These are all glorification of what ashrama? Grihastha ashrama. Karmani abhipravrittaha, very much involved. And in the next verse, sannyasam karmanam cha shamsasi, you are also glorifying the renunciate, the one who has given up all the karmas. Where did Krishna glorify him? In the same fourth chapter, in the next verse itself, nirashiryata chittatma tyakta sarva parigraha shariram kevalam karma kurvannapnoti kilbisham. Krishna uses the word tyakta sarva parigraha, the one who has given up all the possessions and relationship, which is the lifestyle of sannyasa. Him also you glorify. Therefore, karmanam sannyasam shamsasi yogam cha. Shankaracharya says, yoga means karmanam anushtanam cha samsasi. Performance of karma you are glorifying, renunciation of karma you are glorifying. You are blowing hot and cold like the politician's election campaign, full of contradiction. So, hey Krishna, tell me, na enna pannanum. So, yathu shreyaha yetayoho. Between these two lifestyles, tell me which one is better. Don't ask me to do both. It is like asking me to eat the cake. Sollalalyo. Have the cake and eat it too. Solli English la sollalalyo. I cannot follow both because they are diagonally opposite. Grihasthashrama and sannyasashrama, karma anushtanam and karma tyaga are diagonally opposite. To perform the karma and to be in the grihasthashrama is opposite to sannyasa ashrama, and to be in the sannyasa ashrama is opposite to grihasthashrama. Therefore, I cannot parallelly follow life of activity and life of seclusion. Society la irunda seclusion mudiyadu, seclusion la irunda society la irukka mudiyadu. Adhanala I cannot follow both, and therefore I have to necessarily choose one of the two. Therefore, yetayoho yekam. Between these two lifestyles, very careful, not between these two sadhanas. Sadhanas la vandu choose pannave mudiyadu. Everybody has to follow both karma yoga and jnana yoga. Here the choice is with regard to what? Lifestyle. Between these two lifestyles, tell me ekam. Tell me which one is better. And then don't make a wishy-washy statement. This is also okay. This is also ipdindal okay da, adu okay da. So ipdi don't give me evasive answer. Sunishchitam tanme bruhi. If you want to take time for thinking, I will have a cup of coffee and wait. But don't ask me to decide. I want to give the decision making to you. You think over and tell me what I should do. So tat sunishchitam me bruhi. So this is Arjuna's question, and Krishna wants to again teach how much patience is required. Sonnati thiruvi thiruvi solanam varunga rupam. This Krishna, out of compassion, repeats the same as though it is new topic. Because if Krishna tells, I have already taught this like that person. So in that wedding, wedding kacheri, kalyana kacheri, shulwadaliyo. So in the wedding concert, generally nobody listens. Because it is meant for camaraderie, you know, speaking to each other, appa vanda enga endu vanda solli the kacheriyam paattu nadandirukom. So these people, nobody to appreciate, there was only one person sitting in front and nodding the head. And the eyes are open, therefore it is not nodding out of sleep. Therefore his eyes are open, and he thought at least one person is listening. And therefore he did Todi Raga Alapana for 1 hour. And this fellow was saying Sabat wonderful and all those things. And he, after the Alapana, Ragam, Tanam, Pallavi, Taniyavartana, Ella Mudinjache. And this person sends a chit. I hear that your Todi Raga is wonderful. Can you please sing Todi Ragam? So if this person doesn't commit suicide, it's only because of powerful prarabdham. Similarly, Krishna cannot say that I have talked about that only in the last 3 chapters. Chana, Arjuna will feel bad, and therefore, as though it is a fresh topic, again Krishna starts from LKD. So he says, Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, Sanyasa Karma Yogascha, Nisreyasa Karavubhau, tayostu karma sannyasat. Karma yogo visishyate. So first Krishna points out that both ashramas are equally good. Because as far as plus and minus points are concerned, every ashrama has got its own pluses and minuses. That is the nature of the world. That is why in the Vedanta, the world is called Dvandva. It's a beautiful name. Dvandva means nothing in the creation is absolutely good. Everything in the creation will have its own minus point. Only akkaraki ikkara pate. Rented house is better or own house is better. You interview both types of people, they will come out with the problem.